Hi friends, I'm Keizle and today I'm going to show you my process on how I created my July digital planner using my iPad, so let's begin. I'm going to create a monthly digital planner which I can add in my yearly digital planner which I created last January. If you want to see my process and how I created this yearly digital planner, I will add the link of the video in the description box below. I'm using the digital illustration I created from the last video, so if you are also interested on my process, you can check the description box below. Right now, I'm creating the first page after the cover page of the monthly digital planner. This page will be my monthly task overview. I will be writing my tasks here, which will be separated by week. I first turned on the drawing assist and adjusted the grid size, then divided the space into 5 sections. The first 4 sections will be the weekly spaces and the last one will be the space where I will write down my goals for the month. I am also adding this grid design in the space so that it would be easier for me to write when using the digital planner. And the great thing about creating a digital planner is the copy and paste, so that is what I did for this weekly spaces. After creating my basic design, I exported them as PNG files and went to Keynote to create the digital planner. I used the same dimensions as the yearly digital planner that I am using and plan on adding this digital planner into. And since the designs I just created in the Procreate app are just the basic designs, I am adding them in the slide layout in the Keynote app. I finalized the design for the monthly overview of task page by adding the labels of each of the space. Week 1 is for July 1 to 10, week 2 is for July 11 to 17, week 3 is for July 18 to 24, and week 4 is for July 25 to 30, and lastly, the goals space. I also added a small calendar in the goals space and I plan on adding links on the calendar later on. The next page is the calendar page. I'm not sure how I will be using this page yet. I might use this as a memory page where I add pictures to remind me how the days of July went. I created this kind of memory pages last January to March and I was looking back to this recently and I really appreciate this kind of page, so I thought I should incorporate the page to my digital planners again. Although I don't plan on sharing the video process on how I will be creating the page, but let me know if you are interested. And also, I do have 3 video processes I created a few months back, so you can also check those out. The next page that I am creating is the habit tracker. And recently, I have been tracking a lot of habits and I usually add them as tasks for the day. But this month, I wanted to just have a habit overview page, hence I created this. After creating 1 design for the tracker, I just duplicated it numerous times to create 12 trackers. And the 12 things that I will be tracking are sleep, cold showers, 10-minute walks, eating fruits, or drawing digitally and traditionally. I also want to track when I close the rings in my Apple Watch. And lastly, the Japanese stuff, which are lessons and reviews in Wanikani. And if I read and studied using the Genki books. The next page is my explore page. I just added the explore title and the small calendar in the lower right corner. I will leave this page empty for now because I will be using this one for a memory keeping page but for a specific day or event which I think deserves a dedicated page. Now is the time to create the weekly pages. Since I'm already using the Keynote app, I will be using the shapes to add the daily spaces. I will also be using tables for grid lines. To make the design look more cohesive, I have copied the dates design from the calendar page to this page. I will also be doing that on the next weekly pages. If you are following along and you start your week on a Saturday or any other day except Monday, make the necessary changes because my digital planner starts on a Monday. For every weekly page, I'm also adding a note space above the small calendar. For the next weekly page, it will only contain 7 days, so I just copied some of the daily spaces and the calendar and the note space. I usually have more tasks during the weekend, so I am adjusting the space for Saturday and Sunday to fit in the lower space of the weekly page. And since I just copied this from the last weekly page, I am changing their dates and days of the week. This again is what I love about creating digital planners digitally. I can use the copy and paste method. Since the next week has the same number of days, I just duplicated this slide layout again and changed the dates and the days of the week. I also duplicated this page again for the last week of the month. And since there are only 6 days, I decided to just add a space where I can write down my plans and goals for the next month. And if you know me, I love journaling, so I also created a slide layout for that. I only added the transparent background and the grid lines in this page. Now is the time to actually create the digital planner in the presentation mode. If you want to make your digital planner respond faster, make sure to watch my ultimate tip for a lag-free digital planner before proceeding. The arrangement is the monthly overview for tasks page, then the calendar page slash memory page, then the habit trackers, then the explorer page, then the weekly pages. And after every weekly page is the journaling page. And since we are creating a digital planner, I'm also going to add the links for easy navigation. In the monthly overview of tasks page, I want to access the specific weekly pages from here, so I am adding their links. If you are using shapes to add the links, make sure to reduce the opacity to 0 so that the links are invisible. I copied the links of this small calendar and added it to each of the calendars in all of the pages, including all the calendars in the habit tracker. I also added the same links in the calendar page. I just made the shapes for the links bigger. And of course, make sure to lower the opacity again to make the links invisible. In each of the journaling pages, I also want to access their specific weekly pages, so I added invisible links in the July 2022. And once satisfied with the design, I exported it as a PDF file and added it to my yearly planner in GoodNotes. And here is the flip through of my July digital planner. If you have any questions about digital planning or my process of digital planner creation, make sure to leave them in the comment section below. I am Keizle, and until next time, bye!